guys, we're in Georgia in city Gudauri, and it's new year 2023. We're in the biggest ski resort in Georgia with an excellent conditions for free riding. Also, avalanche risk is minimal due to steep slopes. According to preliminary estimates, this is one of the cheapest ski resorts in the world. So let's explore how everything works and how much it costs to rest here.
Let's take a walk through local rentals first.
There are many rentals on the ski resorts. Here you could find different skis, boots, poles. The prices are practically the same. $15 for a day or $100 for a week for all equipment. If you want to take snowboard plus boots, the prices will be the same. If you want to take the full set of clothes with helmets and glasses and gloves, it will cost $26 for one day.
It's better to change the cash and blessing in advance and not in Gudauri.
And as we see, there is no snow in the mountain. The same situation in other resorts in Europe. So this is how the ski entertainment works. If you read information in the official site in Gudauri, you will see that ski season lasts until December to April. In fact, it cannot be predicted. The season with good snow cover starts in the middle of January and lasts until the middle of the March.
If you want to try something special for pro riders, you should try the local heli-ski. Package for the whole day for 4 people plus guide plus 5 helicopter lifts cost $3,050. Non-ride cost $4,550.
That little track that you can see has been artificially snowed. It doesn't fit to the norms of good skiing. The track is curved, the snow cover is thin, and it's not prepared with a snowcat. The lift works, but only for people without equipment. With skis and snowboards, they are not allowed. So you will ask me how we could get to the top, and I will answer you on foot. Of course, for the beginners who will never skate it, it will be okay for some days. But what about amateurs and professionals? Okay, they could ride if they go upstairs on foot. But it's not very comfortable, and you need to use all your energy and all your strength to get upstairs. Oh, let's look on these guys. They are doing their business while the lift isn't working for skiing and snowboarding. I don't know why. The lift reach people for $19 and it's only for one lift. I think it's very expensive. For comparison, one day ski pass without restrictions costs here $26, and you could do approximately 15 lifts like in a snow machine for the whole day. Okay, let's try with no snow and with what we have and try to ski.
Demons quiet, yeah, we were built to thrive, yeah. I think that we've all had enough. Now I'd like to show you the place we're staying in. And this is our apartment. Let's go in. It's the first floor. This is reception where you could stay your keys if you want. Welcome to our home. This is the place where we're living. And we've got bed, sofas, kitchen, and of course the perfect view to the mountain. What could be more perfect? One day here costs $60. Or you could rent for 1 month for $1,400. This is a card from our apartments, and you can use it to open your closet where you could keep your ski, snowboard, boots, and everything you want. And it's very comfortable to turn on here and go outside from this side. We are in a Georgian restaurant, and here you could see traditional Georgian food. And this is khinkali, some bread a little bit with meat. And this is khachapuri, jarski. And practically all Georgian people eat this meal. This is really tasty and very, very wonderful. I know it because I tasted it before. And here we will try two. Oh, it's a little bit hot. Oh, it's necessary to eat with your hands. Meat is wonderful. Also, I ordered some sour cream because I love it, and I do it like this.
Today we arrived in Vartsla, and I decided to eat national Georgian salad with tomatoes, some salad and cucumbers, and also walnut. It's very popular in Georgia. Nothing special, but very good to eat. How would you rate this resort? Write your comments. What about me? The prices here are very pleasant. Georgian people are very friendly. The national cuisine is very full and tasty. But I'd like to notice,
electricity disappears once a week as a standard. This also affects the cabin for skiing and snowboarding. Snow machines don't work in the proper mode. The lake from where they take water is too small. Local people don't allow foreign certified instructors to work with their group.
If we take into account that this year Georgia is hosting freestyle and freeride qualified championship from 19th of February to the 5th of March, I think that all of this is unacceptable. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel, put likes, and press the bell to be the first who knows about new videos.